Welcome to the Ladies Talk Show. This is your host, Leah Richeimer. Thank you so much for joining us. It's very, very dangerous when we try and judge other people because you have no clue what really goes on in that home. Maybe it could be that he is up every night doing the diapers and lets her sleep in, and he works two jobs or whatever, and she doesn't get paid all the things she's supposed to do. She's not getting anything done, and he says, listen, I have a deal with you. Let me sit like a mensch on Shabbos table. That's really important to me, to just sit there and let everybody wait on me. I do all the stuff the rest of the week. This day, now I need to be taken care of. And she says, okay, you got yourself a deal. So we can judge and we can want to strangle him, but we really don't know what's going on there. And it's dangerous too, actually, because if you give her a hint that she should be unhappy, that's enough for a woman to cause a lot of problems in the marriage. So for this particular issue with this woman who you're saying, you know, the husband, you know, how he's being, you are so frustrated, you have to know one thing. You are hearing one side of the story. The scale that you're using to judge them is whether it's the equal amount of work, right? I don't know that that's necessarily, that's something handed us to by the Western society, which said that's how you judge a relationship is equal work, you know? In the workplace, 100%, should be equal work for equal pay. I'm totally with you there. At home, equal, it's like the wrong scale to use. It only causes damage, divorce, horrible things. Maybe the way to judge it, maybe he's giving her heaps of emotional support and she's giving him physical support. You know, who knows? Who knows what's going on? I promise you, we can't judge. The other issue is that for whatever reason, God gave her a husband who sits at the head of the table and doesn't help. Now, should he be improving his character traits? 100,000%. He should be working towards being a better person. But can we judge whether that's what she needed? Let's say she, her whole life, you know, was lazy and never did things for her parents, never did anything for everybody. And this is her takana, right, this is her, now she has everything heaped on her, everything's on her shoulder to do all of the work and to be there for everybody, and maybe that's what she needs to purify and to improve her own soul. We can't judge. I'm just saying it's very dangerous territory when you're looking over the garden and seeing somebody else's house because it seems so simple and pat, and for a million different reasons, emotional, physical, spiritual things which we can't even begin to measure. It is what it is. So unless you're their therapist and you're sitting down and you can actually make some recommendations of how they should live their life and what they should be doing and how they should be doing it, then it's best to just, like you said, completely stay out of it.